CQDX, CQDX, CQDX. This is Havana calling. CQDX, CQDX, CQDX. This is Radio Havana calling all shortwave listeners and radio amateurs. Welcome to... DXers Unlimited, Radio Havana's weekly feature dedicated to the fascinating world of radio communication.
Radioaficionados all around the world, facing the worst high-frequency propagation conditions since amateurs started to use each other back to communicate almost 100 years ago, even more. Solar Cycle 24 had a peak way back in 2014, and it was the weakest one registered in 2 centuries. Very weak peak. Now, the tail end of Cycle 24 is giving us extremely low monthly solar transfer times. Very, very low. 0000. As a direct consequence, the use of single sideband phones and common viewer modes like PSK31 has gone down dramatically. As more and more of the world's radio amateurs learn about the communication of FTH-DNA that can recover signals very deep into the noise. FTH started to become popular 2 years ago, and that led to creating a club, the FTH Club. We are now celebrating the anniversary, second anniversary. FTH is the most club, second anniversary in celebration. 8 special event stations will be active from August 10 to 24 to celebrate the second anniversary of the FTH DNA Club, FTH DNC. All stations use a cloud prefix of FTDNC or FTDN. Special QSL cards containing all QSLs and logs will be uploaded to log out to the world and eQSL. The special event stations are, and here's the full list, Alpha 91 FTDNC by then operator A92 Alpha Alpha. QSL-DF-592-AFA. I have paid Italy operator India Kilo 8 Yankee Fox Ultra QSL via the same. LX8FDN Luxembourg operators LX1PI, LX1JH, and LX1PI. Oscar Delta 5 FTDNC, Lebanon operator Oscar Delta 5 Tango Echo, QSL-DF-K3 India Romeo Victor, your station. Oscar Echo 19, FT, DNT, Oscar operators, Oscar Echo 1, Sierra Red Infant, and Oscar Echo 4, CSLBA, the Oscar Echo 1, S, new CSL information. Tango Night 8, FTDN, from France, F1 ULQ, and X4, CSB, CSLBA, the F1 ULQ address. Tango Oscar 8, FTDN, Guadalupe Island in the Caribbean operators FDH Oscar Juliet, USLBA, F1 ULQ. Sulu Lima 6 FTDNC from New Zealand operator Sulu Lima 1 Mike Victor Lima, USLBA, F1 ULQ. The new prefixes will certainly turn up to more activity because this contact will not lose the opportunity to have one work and confirm at the same time. That's a unique characteristic of the video FTA mode that sends and receives a packet for 13, yes, 13 characters to complete. And I cannot do that to yourself, but in case I need a CSS backup to the virtual registration. Jamie is getting a friend, Nina Samir, around the world. FTA mode is keeping amateurs active, but let me say that the new mode does not have to promote friendship campaigning the book because its limited access to those taking active characters sent and received. Some amateurs are now again experimenting with the Olivia Theater mode because it seems to provide an opportunity on the full propagation condition to carry on a keyboard to give us yourself in the reasonable time frame. It is at CFP13, my amateur. In general, yes, where you play every time that there is even a slight improvement on the silver preparation condition, I have a chance to see what you do. Now, let me put my watch here. Due to another breakdown of my changes here, H20X has been to my gear, but you already said, seems to be impossible to repair due to the large number of electrolytic capacities that are in poor shape after many decades of use. Still, too difficult to repair. USL on the air to move around our seat in this track, which sent a very interesting email about an experimental antenna he's now using for the shortwave band. It is yet another configuration with a terminated long wire and easy to spot antenna because it does not imply a physical length at all. Many years ago, while doing experiments with VHF D-type antennas, I used two three-row bundles at the end of the plate of the D antenna, floating antenna connected to the other end of the resistor to the ground plane and ground rod. The terminator B was directional and worked very well picking up for a big shift, the signal 6 meters I work on the TV camera from 56 years at this and there's a lot of TV reaction in the years 1950 and 1960. These are the receiver on the phone that means they were a later respected transmitting on 10 and 2 minutes with also good results. It was also low FWR. 12 years later, we're moving to a new house. And then I had the chance to install the full set of high frequency radio to a antenna and mast and towers. I found nearby buildings from 50 meters away from where was one of the random networks to be attacked. The aim was connected to a 4-to-1 volume and the attack satellite to the antenna tuner, a wide fiber and a quarter time of work antenna tuner. It was nice to see how well the final network was more than 82 meters above our new radio determined the entire pattern for this band. It worked, but we don't know where you're sending the unit or where it's coming. Then someone suggested to attack the end of the running wire to a 6-inch gunny road and using the station's ground ID. Connecting the structure cable, we considered a T-type structure connector. It was no surprise that the rest of the antenna radio as expected and just to the user signal and for the radio where it is a lot of use. Our bands were also bringing back good results, very similar to what a major band was from Utah has achieved with this terminated non-wire antenna. Yes, amigos, this is Radio Havana Cuba, we're broadcasting to the world via shortwave, streaming to the internet from www.radio8.cu. We're also on the FM broadcast master of frequency here for Cuba, in Western Cuba and D. And inserted into the digital TV multicaster of all the Cuban television services, the DCMDP. And the hosts are Arnaldo and Nicola, and here's our next topic here at DXers Unlimited. Aurora Borealis is placed in North America in the middle of the summer. Yes, they have happened Monday evening with enough intensity so that they could be seen in areas of the TV with high levels of street lights. This summer aurora in the USA may happen again Tuesday evening because a fast moving stream of solar wind hit Earth's magnetic field into high intensity variations. For example, we have a geomagnetic storm and aurora in the entire US state due to a stream to the city light level. Currently, the solar wind is increasing to 400 kilometers per second, which means more northern lights are possible Tuesday evening. We would like to visit www.spaceweather.com for more information and updates about this aurora borealis event. Send us any reports and comments about this program and also the radio holiday questions. I'm most welcome and answer as soon as possible. And then I forward on our database for future use by our listeners. I said earlier, so we have already been using them. This is your magnetic disturbances in progress right now. Our mailing address is info@gmail.com and the postal service company at Arnold Corley. That's Charlie Oscar Romeo Oscar, my last name, Arnold Corley. Radio Havana Cuba, Havana Cuba.
And that's all for today. This is Arnie Coro, Radio Amateur CO2KK, your host here at Radio Havana, DXers Unlimited, saying 73 and very good DX.
Once a week here on Radio Havana Cuba, we have the weekend edition of DXers Unlimited and the midweek edition of DXers Unlimited with Arnie Corley.